This is a Nightline Friday night special.
No, Thursday's out. How about never? Is never good for you?
Actually, I preferred heaven too, but then the marketing guys got hold of it.
I think a New Yorker cartoon really captures, you know, in one sort of pithy stroke, the follies of our time.
The New Yorker is the major cartoon archive of the 20th century. It's really a chronicle, a comic chronicle of the entire century.
Both timely and timeless, they hold a funhouse mirror up to our lives.
How's the squid?
I seem to have missed the cup.
They're delicious. We can't pass them up. You know, we gotta eat this little bonbon. And then, what the hell, we'll finish the rest of the box.
Tonight, Drawing Laughter, the cartoonists of the New Yorker magazine.
From ABC News, this is Nightline. Reporting from Washington, Ted Koppel.
There is, if you analyze it too closely, absolutely nothing funny about the cartoon which shows the condemned man kneeling under the guillotine as the executioner holding two baskets asks, paper or plastic? And yet the cartoons of Tom Chaney have amused millions of Americans for many years. The cartoons of Charles Adams, equally ghoulish, have evolved into a hugely successful television series, and then more than 20 years later into a couple of hit movies featuring the Adams family. There is, especially at this time of year, something both whimsical and satisfying about Mr. Adams' family tipping a cauldron of boiling oil on a hapless chorus of holiday carolers. It is not something we would ever do or even want to do, but it strikes a chord, which, in the final analysis, is what a successful cartoon always does. It taps into the jumble of cliches and insights, frustrations and resentments that swirl around inside each of us, and produces that rare combination of recognition and humor. Which is why, when freelance producer Dora Militaro came to us and proposed that we devote a program to a special edition of The New Yorker, devoted entirely to its cartoonists, we immediately latched onto the idea and asked Dora to help us do it.
You all look like you're going to a funeral instead of a party.
Do we have the top hat, please? Give me the Viking helmet, please.
Give him a bottle over here.
Can I have your attention, please? Look happy, everybody.
One, two, three.
42 New Yorker magazine cartoonists have gathered at a Manhattan photo studio for a class photo of sorts. The class has grown during the last half century, and a few of the subjects from this 1947 photograph are on hand today.
I'm still here 50 years later.
I started in 1941.
They have all come to be photographed for the first issue devoted entirely to the subject of cartoons. A celebration of the single-panel magazine cartoon, a form created by The New Yorker in 1925 with its first issue. It's a fond look back, but also a turning point.
He's such a passionate nurturer of the art of cartooning.
New Yorker editor Tina Brown is appointing Bob Mankoff, a staff cartoonist for 20 years, as the new cartoon editor.
So, Bob, we salute you, and we salute all of you here today.
Mankoff reveres the magazine's traditions, but is already bringing in a few digital age touches.
In the New Yorker history, it's published 58,000 cartoons. 58,000 cartoons, which I have right here on this disc, which is virtual. Damn. Oh, God. Back up.
I chose Bob Mankoff because I find his cartoons, for a start, some of the best that we ever buy.
As a matter of fact, you did catch us at a bad time.
I try to keep my people as expressionless as possible, and that cuts down on the labor.
He's got a very edgy, very contemporary, very original, very funny, very risky kind of humor. And I found I was always buying his stuff.
No, I don't want to play chess. I just want you to reheat the lasagna. Personally, I like the New York Times in color.
They can't see you right now. Would you like a bottle while you're waiting?
The cartoon is the visual equivalent of the epigram, I suppose. You know, the one-liner that'll sum up a mood, a thought, a worldview. If it's done right, it has a universality that only the best wit can achieve.
It's a way of dealing with the complexities of the world by reducing them to a comic situation rather than a 42-page government report. And that's why very few cartoonists are in government. Next victim.
As cartoon editor, Mankoff now presides over the New Yorker's Tuesday morning ritual in which the staff artists, like religious supplicants, bring in a full week's work, hoping that just one cartoon will find favor.
Have we schmoozed enough?
Yeah.
All right, get out. You know, one of the things about being a cartoonist, you know, you have to get put up with is the constant rejection, because 95% of your work is being rejected. And I've got to say, it's easier rejecting than being rejected.
And to add to the cartoonist's agony, Mankoff usually scans their work with a stone face.
Kind of quiet in here.
Oh, it's quiet, but inside my mind is ricocheting with laughter. Laughter is about surprise. And let's face it, you become very hard to surprise when you've seen, you know, 50,000 cartoons. You almost become a little bit like a humor mechanic.
But every now and then...
That's it. He won the lottery, he got the laugh. Everybody go home.
The cartoon also passes the laugh test at the final art meeting.
It's going in the other direction, I think, very funny.
Hey, big guy, can I buy you a pair of underpants?
Laughing is the prime reason we buy these cartoons.
They're delicious. We can't pass them up. You know, we gotta eat this little bonbon. And then, what the hell, we'll finish the rest of the box.
And Bob Mankoff has gorged on a lot of cartoons. He loves them, knows their history, and can rattle off favorites like a cartoon computer.
Jack Ziegler, sensational cartoonist, he had over 700 cartoons published in the magazine. And let's see, one of his, this is a funny cartoon, the naked guy there is actually from a cartoon where he's looking in a closet, and the only thing on the hanger, you know, is a leaf, and it's called Simpler Times. I'm thinking of a wonderful, wonderful cartoon of his. It's called January 3rd at Rockefeller Center. Just the idea that the day after at Rockefeller Center, it would be just like everything else. Leo Cullum, Leo's doing great stuff with dogs. I mean, the dog's saying, I'll have a scotch and toilet water. Recently, an issue where we had an hysterically funny Gay and Wilson cartoon. It has a guy at a pizza place. His mouth is enormous. Looks like this.
I guess as soon it wasn't cut into those funny little pieces, if you don't mind.
It's clear. He's just going to... Charles Borsatti, I don't know what the... it's a piece of pasta. He's on the phone. And he's saying the phone.
Fusilli, you crazy bastard. How are you?
There's a funny Sidney Harris cartoon in which death comes to the door. But he's short and small, not tall. And he's saying to the guy...
Don't worry. I'm just a sore throat.
I had a cartoon in which I had death, but he had like a Hawaiian shirt and Bermudas on and everything. And the guy is saying, you call this death with dignity?
Will that be all, sir?
Cartoons deal directly with death, and they should, as humor should. I mean, you can't make any jokes after you're dead. So, I mean, you know, make fun of death. Death is going to make fun of you.
All of which brings us to the New Yorker magazine's Cartoon Graveyard.
Of all the cartoons in scrapbook form that have ever appeared in the magazine, each artist has a book in which on the spine of the book is the year you started, 1977. They wait till you die, and then they put in the final number. So here these are great scrapbooks, sort of like tombstones that exist for our creative careers. And if all the places, the final resting place, when I'm ready to go, this is good enough for me.
When we come back, life, one frame at a time, inside the world of three New Yorker cartoonists.
This is ABC News Nightline, brought to you by MasterCard.
Two season tickets to the opera, $950. Velvet wrap, $170. Opera glasses, $82. 9 guaranteed dates with your husband, priceless. There are some things money can't buy. For everything else, there's Platinum MasterCard, with a high spending limit for the things that matter.
The Toyota Camry has been called a benchmark for all mid-price sedans. Automobile Magazine called Camry the best car built in America. It's America's favorite car. And to celebrate, Toyota's offering special leases and low APR financing on new Camrys, but only until January 5th. So see your Toyota dealer today and call Camry the best thing of all, yours.
Sunday on This Week, will President Clinton defy Republicans by appointing Bill Lan-Lee as head enforcer of civil rights? And will Republicans retaliate? This Week Sunday.
Do you believe that Christmas wishes come true?
Hi, I'm Ann Holt, standing right here at the bank lobby.
Ann Holt, let's go.
Good evening, I'm Bob Mueller.
Mom, time for dinner.
Thanks, Mom. We'll be right back.
Lisa, honey, why don't you go out and play? It's beautiful outside.
But, Mom, the barometer is falling, and we're expecting a storm before noon.
Who says Christmas wishes don't come true? Happy holidays from News 2.
Yes, ma'am. Right away, ma'am. Uh-oh. Better get Mako.
When the unexpected happens, get Mako's Ambassador Paint Service for $149.95.
Storm Tracker 2000, exclusively on News 2. Zeroing in on severe weather with pinpoint accuracy. Tracking the path of striking storms, giving you earlier warnings. See weather like you've never seen it before. Storm Tracker 2000, exclusively on News 2.
The whole idea of being something called a cartoonist. It's undignified and freakish.
Actually, seeing him stride down Park Avenue, the last thing you would take William Hamilton for is a cartoonist. He looks every inch the patrician wasp, all 6 feet 5 inches, in fact. He could be one of his own upper crust characters. Only his socks give him away.
I think people naturally draw who they are and what they know.
And what Hamilton knows are the foibles of the rich.
I draw privately educated people bumbling through life. I have no idea where she came from or who she is, but she does look a little pompous. As I think this interview will prove, being unaware of your own pomposity is always funny.
Is Pinot Noir where you want to be?
There are a few things I always can return to. One is, if I draw a couple of old goats talking to each other in very expensive suits, all I have to do is think of something enormously childish for them to say to each other, and it's funny.
I was a ruthless, driven, unfeeling son of a bitch, and it worked out extremely well. I sold my soul for about a tenth of what the damn things are going for now.
Oh, yes, we know them. We hate them.
That whole world, he described a whole world of social interactions in that. Oh, yes, we know them. We hate them.
I think the greatest cartoonists create their own universe and a cast of characters and a way of looking at the world that becomes immediately identifiable as theirs. I think today Roz Chast has the same kind of universe in her work.
Roz Chast's cartoon universe is rooted in her real world, that of the average suburban mom. Only the wild Halloween decorations on her family's house mark it as the residence of a cartoonist and a lifelong fan of Charles Adams' ghoulish Adams family.
Everybody has their family of people, I guess, and these are mine.
And from her drawing board come off-kilter scenes of the middle class, shot through with neuroses and fraught with domestic peril.
Midlife crises of appliances. It's just, you know, appliances when they've hit that difficult stage in life between birth and death.
Roz actually invites us in. It's like you're donning these, after a while, these virtual reality Roz glasses. And all of a sudden, you're in her world.
I do find anxiety very, very, very funny.
Mental baggage claim.
Oh, there's my hypochondria coming out right now.
Those lifelong regrets about stopping ballet lessons when I was 10, those are mine.
Excuse me, I believe I see my resentment of physical beauty.
I love very serious science articles. Those articles about scientists discovering the universe is twice as wide as we thought it was. And I'm thinking, like, well, how wide did you think it was?
Scientists discover the gene for heterosexuality in men.
Stoic indifference to Judy Garland.
Fear of asking directions.
Urge to join Shriners.
Desire to eat steak and eggs for breakfast.
It's a very fine line between, you know, being absolutely terrified of something.
Obituaries.
And finding it incredibly hilarious how terrifying it is.
3 years your junior. 5 years your senior. Exactly your age. Your age. On the dot.
Hey, Odie.
I go to bed at usually 6 or 7 in the morning and try to get up by noon.
Michael Crawford is going to work at his upstate New York farmhouse.
Gotta work, you guys.
But this is sunset, not sunrise. And he keeps a cartoonist's schedule, not farmer's hours.
I see this great 6-hour slot when I basically I can paint completely undisturbed, no one else is up. Music I love. I listen to music all the time. Everything, as long as it's loud.
I eat antipasta twice just because she is so nice, Angelina. Angelina, waitress at the pizzeria.
I don't think I'm ever going to be a virtuoso. The idea is really to get the basic information in as few lines as possible.
Zoom, 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 zoom.
Lately, Michael Crawford has been obsessed in his painting and his New Yorker cartoons with organized crime figures.
The mob that I'm portraying is a lot more glamorous in some sense. I mean, obviously, sartorially, everybody looks great, but when you actually see mobsters in the papers today, they're just in cheap jogging suits. You know, it's a real disappointment.
It's pretty simple, Jimmy. We get you some ice cream and then we throw you off to Verrazano. You got a problem with that?
Doorman to Maz Gunman. Will he know what this is regarding?
We've got a very suave hitman just arrived.
Sorry I'm late, Dal. I had to whack this f***. Then his Chinese takeout shows up.
Michael Crawford's obsession with the mob, it's not going to do him any good. He's going to come to a bad, bad end.
I love the mob. It's just sheer romance. Everybody can understand that.
Dad, what's that? Dad, it's a bear.
I'll check. Everything's fine.
Would Nightline help, son?
Every day, car batteries are put to the test. And every day, America's most trusted lives up to its name. Die Hard. Tried and true.
Ha ha, Dad. Very funny.
I don't know where it could be, honey.
The diner. Do you know the name?
Don't worry, okay? You gotta try.
And have a little faith in me.
AT&T 00 Info.
I think we left a beanie baby in a diner somewhere in New York.
Oh dear, that is a problem. Do you remember the name?
Dill something near Kingston.
To start.
Introducing AT&T 00 Info.
I've got a Dilly's Diner in Linebeck.
That's it.
I think we found it.
The assistance is back in directory assistance.
Coming up.
If you're in a restaurant and OJ comes in, are you going to stay?
I would not only stay, I'd try to get him on the show.
Politically Incorrect with Bill Maher, coming up on ABC Late Night.
Come to Shoney's, where we say good morning with a great breakfast.
starting at $3.99 for the unlimited breakfast bar. Served hot and fresh every weekday morning starting at $3.99. Shoney's for breakfast. Mm-mm, let's eat. Come to Shoney's and enjoy pasta your way. Choose any pasta and sauce starting at $5.99. Add a topping for a little more. And dinner comes with the unlimited salad bar. Shoney's for pasta starting at $5.99. Mm-mm, let's eat.
Hi, I'm Troy Aikman, and this is my official NFL jacket I got from Just for Feet.
Get real.
I'm Marcus Allen with my Logo Athletic Kansas City Chiefs jacket.
Get real.
And I'm Dan Marino with my real authentic Pro-Line jacket.
Get real. Get Logo Athletic at Just for Feet.
For all your favorite real team jackets, there's only one team to join.
Logo Athletic and Just for Feet. Be a part of our team.
Get real Logo Athletic team apparel this week at Just for Feet.
Just for Feet and Logo Athletic, a winning team.
Stop. Don't pay retail prices for your computer needs. Come to the Computer Show and Sale.
Saturday and Sunday in Nashville.
It's like you can't go to any other one place and find this many different products in one location.
Single chip. Full computer. Super VGA. CD-ROM. At the Computer Show and Sale this weekend. Millions in merchandise, lots of friendly help. Prices so low they blow the stores away.
This Saturday and Sunday at Tennessee State Fairgrounds in Nashville.
Department.
We have a great tradition at the Algonquin going back that many of the artists and writers of New Yorker used to have lunch at the famous Algonquin Round Table.
New Yorker cartoon editor Bob Mankoff reveres the magazine's past. In homage to the celebrated wits who gathered at the hotel's Round Table in the 1920s and 30s, he has created a Cartoonists Round Table, where the artists come together to dine, trade quips, and talk shop.
If you were a cartoon editor, as I am now, what would you do differently?
I would get rid of you.
But Mankoff is also bringing cartooning into the digital age.
Cast of thousands, or at least...
For the cover of the special cartoon issue, Mankoff used a computer to construct a collage of cartoonists' characters from the 1920s to today.
There's George Booth's dog over here. Here's a sort of slimy Michael Crawford character putting the moves on a William Hamilton waspy gal, Peter Arno and James Stevenson. So all the artists, almost the entire history of the magazine, you know, is going to be represented past and present in this cover.
Is that moon new?
The moon is Steig's moon from a very famous cartoon.
With the first all-cartoon issue, Mankoff and editor Tina Brown look to celebrate a comic art form that has become a signature of the magazine.
So I think this should be classics for our time or something like that. Just make it two spreads of things that, you know, essentially I know people are going to laugh at.
The cartoons are such a sort of national treasure that people almost take them for granted. And it seemed like a good idea to, in a way, with one special issue, remind people of just how much they love these cartoons.
Whenever Mother's Day rolls around, I regret having eaten my young.
Before I forget, Dietrich, here's the dental plan. Congratulations! It's a bitch!
Would you please remove your license from your collar?
Lassie! Get help!
Next frame, you see Lassie is on the psychiatrist's couch. Lassie got help.
Look! Land! We're saved!
Look! A raft! We're saved!
And I did a cartoon in 1984, which had a guy on an island, and took up the whole island, and he's thinking...
No man is an island, but I come pretty damn close. Surprise party.
I'm flunking out of school!
I want a divorce!
That growth is malignant!
I'm Fragger's daddy!
Your mother.
The boss is saying you're fired. Oh, the most terrible of the surprise it could be.
Welcome to New York. Just kidding. Tunnel of Love. Exit.
She's
Someday man will find a peaceful use for my machines.
The New Yorker really did invent the magazine cartoon. It's something that has to be nurtured and kept alive, and I have every confidence it will. It would actually be, you know, a tragedy for comedy if this didn't happen.
And I'll be back in a moment with a final thought.
The Toyota Camry has been called the best car built in America, and Consumers Digest has selected it as a best buy. So it's little wonder that the Camry has quickly become America's favorite car. And to celebrate, now you can get special leases and low APR financing on Toyota Camry. But only until January 5th. There can be only one favorite car, and there's only one place to get it. So visit your Toyota dealer today.
This is the hardest thing I've ever done. I mean, these people were like family to me. Remember I met Jeannie at the company picnic?
It was the best thing that ever happened to you.
Yeah, taking a new job was a tough decision. Deciding what to do with my 401k money was another. I didn't want to mess it up. I called T. Rowe Price. You know, you told me about the mutual funds.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, well, they sent me a rollover kit, you know. Took me through it step by step.
I made it easy for you.
Yeah, piece of cake.
T. Rowe Price, helping people invest with confidence for over 50 years.
It's going to be a good job.
Yeah.
Save $100 on professional installation and get $50 of programming certificates. So what are you waiting for? Go to your retailer today.
At 14, she won the Grammy for Best New Artist of the Year. Now, Leanne Rimes comes to ABC to tell her very special story. She grew up with a dream.
I'm going to be at the grand old doctor.
But before the world would know her name, she learned the meaning of love.
I want to hear you sing one more time.
With an angel.
Is it really you?
To guide her.
Keep your eye on what's here.
Tony winner Bernadette Peters and Grammy sensation Leanne Rimes star in Holiday in Your Heart, Sunday on ABC.
Connect the numerical Aphidium stabilizer to the Sesprucian CPX? Frankly, I don't need a higher form of intelligence to make smart decisions. No offense. Now during the Chevy Make Your Money Cab year-end event, the Smart Buy is Cavalier. With features usually found on more expensive cars for half the price. Plus now, get 2.9 APR financing or cash back on Cavalier. Check out great offers on other 98 Chevy cars and trucks. You want to look smart? Get a Cavalier. You want to be smart? Get to the Chevy Make Your Money Cab year-end event now. And save big.
Immediately that you didn't belong. For one thing, and this is probably the first time in my life that it's ever been true of me, but I feel too complicated and symmetrical to fit in with this group. Cartoon characters are usually rather simple, even though they tend toward exaggerated features. Also, unlike most of us in real life, they don't talk unless they have something to say. And then they say it in no more than a line or two. Truth of the matter is that I know the New Yorker has this great reputation for brilliant writing and sophisticated humor, but there's only one reason I ever pick up the magazine. You know what I'm talking about. Everybody in this room knows what I'm talking about. That's our report for tonight. I'm Ted Koppel in Washington. For all of us here at ABC News, good night.
If you'd like a transcript or video cassette of this or any other edition of Nightline, please dial 1-800-CALL-ABC. Nightline is always on with abcnews.com, on the web, or AOL.
Nightline has been a presentation of ABC News. More Americans get their news from ABC News than from any other source. ABC News, now always on.